everyone! I thought I'd make a quick guide to explain my damage calculator. This is a project I've been working on and have poured many hours into, between counting all the frame data, to compiling the information, and then working on many layers of logic to make the calculations as accurate as possible. This is where the numbers in my videos come from.
Holy shit. Holy fucking shit. I see numbers, it must be true.
Let's go over a few things. 1. How to use the calculator. 2. How it works. 3. Shortcomings of theorycrafting. Note: remember to always take theorycrafting with a grain of salt, as it's just that, theory. It's not 100% perfect, but it gives us a general idea of where things stand. Using the calculator is simple enough. Select your simulacrum from the dropdown, and optionally, matrices. Additionally, input in your stats to account for elemental biases in your damage output. There are also some additional modifiers here, which we'll go into later. You don't have to worry about them for now. Then, that's it! If you scroll down, you'll see an estimation of the total damage percent per minute dealt by this team, as well as the damage distribution types. Alternatively, the spread box near the top has this DPM value inside of it, so you don't have to scroll down. So, how do these calculations actually work? Let's start from the beginning with the inputs. The stat input is simply a weighted system that weights your highest attack at 100%. This is to weight down values appropriately, instead of scaling them up. After all, it's not a calculator to see how good your gear is. It's to compare different setups with gear as a constant. Next, we have two modifiers, for precision and practicality. These are modifiers that can be input in order to reduce the values of some skills that just aren't practical to land, or require macro like precision, or both. How is the total damage calculated? Every simulacrum has various fields for its basic attack DPS, endurance DPS, endurance usage, etc. The damage values are all measured by counting the frames for each skill sequence and dividing the damage amount by the time. The calculator then maximizes the total damage output by prioritizing your highest damage in each category, taking into account constraints such as total dodge or endurance. There are some special cases, such as Meryl A5, where it's assumed you only switch into her while shielded. Additionally, some skills are prioritized, such as dodge attacks from Tsubasa to upkeep the buff, Saki branch for Surge, etc. Some units and matrices also have passive damage. This is calculated using an average of on-field multipliers. For example, Lin's Nightblooms can benefit from other weapons' bonus damage effects or matrices, which is weighted appropriately by their total field time derived from previous calculations. Finally, the values for skills, discharges, and basic damage sources are all combined into one metric. Again, it's not perfect, but judging from anecdotes of veteran players, it's decently accurate to get a general idea of where things stand. There are several parts to this calculator that are a bit out of scope to be applied properly. For example, buff amounts are averaged, so bursty comps with short duration buffs, such as that of A6 Krull, may be a bit undervalued. But that being said, there aren't that many of short duration buffs in current team comps anyway. I hope this guide was helpful in understanding how I do my calculations. The damage calculator is a useful tool for estimating the value of both matrices and advancements. But remember to always take theorycrafting with a grain of salt, as there really is no good way to precisely quantify the value of things in an action game where rotations are so volatile. See you guys next time!